reading from Baruch, chapter 5. Arise, O Jerusalem, stand upon the height. Look towards the east and see your children gather from west and east at the word of the Holy One, rejoicing that God has remembered them. For they went out from you on foot, led away by their enemies. But God will bring them back to you, carried in glory as on a royal throne. For God has ordered that every high mountain and the everlasting hills be made low, and the valleys filled up to make level ground, so that Israel may walk safely in the glory of God. The woods and every fragrant tree have shaded Israel at God's command. For God will lead Israel with joy, in the light of his glory, with the mercy and righteousness that come from him. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Grant us your light, O Lord, that the darkness in our hearts, being wholly passed away, we may come at last to the light, which is Christ. For Christ is the morning star, who when the night of the world has passed, brings to his saints the promised light of life, and opens to them eternal day. Of the universe, eternal creator of light and darkness. In this season of Advent, when the sun's light is swallowed up by the growing darkness of the night, you renew your promise to reveal among us the splendor of your glory, made flesh and visible to us in Jesus Christ, your Son. Through the prophets, you teach us to hope for his reign of peace. Through the outpouring of his Spirit, you open our blindness to the glory of his presence. Strengthen us in our weakness. Support us in our stumbling efforts to do your will. And free our tongues to sing your praise. For to you all honor and blessing are due, now and forever. Amen. stand to sing hymn number 480, 480, O Come, O Come, Emmanuel.
Faithfulness He will bring forth justice. He will not falter or be discouraged till he establishes justice on earth. In his law, the islands will put their hope. This is what God the Lord says. He who created the heavens and stretched them out, who spread out the earth and all that comes out of it, who gives breath to its people and life to those who walk on it. I, the Lord, have called you in righteousness. I will take hold of your hand. I will keep you and will make you to be a covenant for the people and a light for the Gentiles. To open eyes that are blind, to free captives from prison, and to release from the dungeon those who sit in darkness. I am the Lord. That is my name. I will not give my glory to another or my praise to idols. See, the former things have taken place, and new things I declare. Before they spring into being, I announce them to you.
We stand now to sing 381, Let All Mortal Flesh Keep Silent.
He will give to all the faith for us.
sit for our third reading. Taken from Isaiah chapter 7. Again the Lord spoke to Ahaz, saying, ask a sign of the Lord your God. Let it be as deep as Sheol, or as high as heaven. But Ahaz said, I will not ask, and I will not put the Lord to the test. Then Isaiah said, hear then, O house of David, is it too little for you to weary mortals, that you weary my God also? Therefore the Lord himself will give you a sign. Look, the young woman is with child, and shall bear a son, and shall name him Emmanuel. He shall eat curds and honey by the time he knows how to refuse the evil and choose the good. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Matthew's Gospel, the birth of Jesus, the Messiah. Now, the birth of Jesus, the Messiah, took place in this way. When his mother Mary had been engaged to Joseph, but before they lived together, she was found to be with child from the Holy Spirit. Her husband Joseph, being a righteous man and unwilling to expose her to public disgrace, planned to dismiss her quietly. But just when he had resolved to do this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child she bears, for the child conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you are to name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins." All this took place to fulfill what had been spoken by the Lord through the prophet. "Look, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and they shall name him Emmanuel," which means God is with us. When Joseph awoke from sleep, he did as the angel of the Lord commanded him. He took her as his wife, but had no marital relations with her until she had borne a son, and he named him Jesus. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Now, our prayers. The response to "Let us pray to the Lord" is, "Lord, hear our prayer." Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Watchful at all times, let us pray for strength to stand with confidence before our Maker and Redeemer. That God may bring his kingdom, may bring in his kingdom with justice and mercy, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God may establish among the nations his scepter of righteousness, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may seek Christ in the Scriptures and recognize him in the breaking of the bread, Lord, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God may bind up the brokenhearted, restore the sick, and raise up all who have fallen, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the light of God's coming may dawn on all who live in darkness and the shadow of death, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That with all the saints in light, we may shine forth as lights in the world. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us commend the world, which Christ will judge, to the mercy and protection of God. And let us pray for those needs that are on our hearts at this time, in a moment of silence. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen. We say together the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Almighty God, give us grace to cast away the works of darkness and to put on the armour of light. now in the time of this mortal life, in which your Son, Jesus Christ, came to us in great humility, that on the last day, when he shall come again in his glorious majesty to judge the living and the dead, we may rise to the life immortal. Through him who is alive and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Thank you. But it's always useful to have something in there.
Mm-hmm. And